Now guys, your VO2 max, the maximal volume of oxygen your body can use, is a good indication of cardiovascular fitness and a strong predictor of longevity. A real VO2 max test involves exercising to failure while wearing a mask. However, there are simple tests you can do to provide an estimate of your VO2 max. One of these is called the Rockport Walking Test. The Rockport Walking Test is a 1 mile walk, which you are to complete as fast as you can. Immediately following the walk, you are to measure your heart rate for 15 seconds. The time taken in the 1 mile walk and your heart rate are then put into a formula alongside your age, sex, and body weight to provide an estimate of your VO2 max. The 1 mile walk should be completed on a flat surface. An athletics track is ideal here because not only is it flat, but it provides an exact measurement of distance. Alternatively, I believe that mobile phone GPS is accurate enough that you could track yourself walking 1 mile in a relatively flat area. Prior to the test, you should spend 3 to 5 minutes warming up. Try to include a few bursts of fast walking to get a feel for the pace you'll have to maintain. You can then give yourself a minute or two to settle before starting. A mile is 1609 meters and one lap of an athletic track from lane one is 400 meters. If you're lucky, the track will have a curved 1 mile start line, a short distance back from the finish line. If not, taking 9 paces back from the finish line is a reasonable enough estimate. From there, you're going to start a timer and walk as fast as you can round the track. You will be doing just over 4 full laps, ending at the finish line. At that point, you will need to stop the timer, note down the time taken if necessary, and then use it to count the number of heartbeats in 15 seconds. If you've been walking as fast as you can, your pulse should be easily located on the side of your neck. You then need to plug your results into the formulas from the original research paper, which are shown here. Your 1 mile time needs to be converted into minutes, so take the seconds and divide by 60 to come up with a decimal time. I took this test twice, once in my local area where there's some uninterrupted stretches of road, and again on an athletics track. I used my mobile phone GPS both times, and found that it very slightly underestimated my track mile as I crossed the line with it at 0.99 miles. My road walk wasn't perfectly flat, so I walked 0.5 mile out and turned around. That way I'm at least starting and finishing at the same height above sea level. Another benefit of the phone is that it records your mile time, so you don't need to remember it after counting your pulse. The difference was about 40 seconds, and as expected, the athletics track allowed me to achieve a higher estimated score. If you look at the coefficients, you can get a feel for how much your estimated VO2 max can change. The factor for the 1 mile time is 3.26, so roughly 1 unit of VO2 max every 18 seconds, meaning my estimated VO2 max from the track walk was 2 units higher. That gives you an idea how much margin for error you have if your walking route involves waiting to cross the road or dodging pedestrians. Your heart rate factor is 0.1565, so if you accidentally counted 35 beats in 15 seconds when the true number is 37, that's a difference of around 1.2 units of VO2 max. As this is an exercise test, it comes with a word of caution. For certain individuals, exercise testing may not be suitable. In particular, anyone with any cardiovascular conditions, high blood pressure, orthopedic issues, severe respiratory conditions like asthma, anyone currently pregnant, or experiencing any cold or flu symptoms at the time of the test. Please speak to a doctor if you're in any doubt as to whether this protocol is safe for you to do. Once you complete the test, you'll probably want to know what your VO2 max score means. Here is the normative data for VO2 max by age and sex. This is just one data set, so it shouldn't be treated as the single source of truth. You can see it moves a lot by age, so a score of 50 is above average for a young man, but by the time he's retirement age, he'd do well to have a VO2 max above 30. A few reference points from the literature: a VO2 max of 25 would be roughly what you'd need to walk up a steep hill, and 35 would be jogging at 6 miles an hour, which is slightly faster than a brisk walk. There is a very well established decline in VO2 max with age, and that will happen regardless of fitness level. The difference is that a fitter individual will remain at a higher level relative to the unfit individual as they both age. It's worth taking a simple test like this once a year and making a note of your score. People typically lose around 1% of their VO2 max per year after the age of 30, so even if you maintain your current activity levels, you will see a decline with age. However, your VO2 max is very much trainable if you're willing to put in the hours. This is particularly true if you don't currently exercise, which would put you at a higher risk as you approach 65 or older. I turned 30 in 2017, which is when the literature would suggest that my VO2 max would start to decline. By increasing the amount of exercise I do, I've been able to reverse the trend, meaning last year I was fitter aged 36 than I was at 26. Thanks for watching.